In the 21st century, the 10th of October 2010. The people of Bonaire were recolonized, displaced and abused as a nation by the Netherlands. A member of the European Union and United Nations. James Vinnies is the first ever Antillean which publicly spoke at the C24 United Nations Special Committee of Decolonization. In 2005, a young commercial banker in his 30s, past president and founding member of NGO platform Bonaire, national player in both tennis and football, abandoned his professional life as a commercial banker and turned human rights activist, the head of the dissolution of the Netherlands Antilles, on October 10, 2010. On the 10th of October, 2010, Bonaire was incorporated and integrated into the Dutch state structure, which was not done in accordance with the UN self-determination rights principles. In his eyes, the politicians and stakeholders of the island lack to have learned from our colonial history and seem to be compromised to follow a Dutch established governmental system that was imposed on us for our division and self-destruction, and not for our emancipation, empowerment and nation-building. James Vinnies wrote hundreds of letters to Prime Minister of the Netherlands, Governor of the Netherlands Antilles, Governor of Bonaire, Parliament of the Netherlands, Queen Beatrix and King Willem-Alexander, Human Rights, International Court of Justice, Kingdom Relations, CARICOM, United Nations, SLAC, UNICER, OAS, APCO and Parlatino. After no response, Mr. James Vinnies founded the Nos Kei Bonaire Ubik, which translated to We Want Bonaire Back, and orchestrated hundreds of protests in and out of Bonaire, which led to what NKBB is today. 2010, Bonaire forced to be part of Holland as public entity without equal rights, making the Bonairean people second-class citizen in the same Dutch kingdom and Dutch constitution. Hence our borders were opened for unrestricted migration of Dutch Europeans through aggressive promotional campaigns in Holland, with incentives to reside on Bonaire with tax holidays and benefits, and they can subsequently vote after 90 days in local election. Mr. Vinnies sacrificed 222 days protesting day and night for referendum. After 2 months, the governor gave Mr. Vinnies and his group 48 hours notice to move and stop protesting, but had to withdraw his order after 100,000 of people came to the governor office and protested to leave Mr. Vinnies so he can continue to protest. Mr. Vinnies refused to leave the government office until a referendum was granted. Referendum the 18th of December, 2015. 5,040 equals 65.55% no rejection. After 222 days of non-stop 24/7 sitting outside the governor's office, the politicians signed an agreement with Mr. Vinnies to give the people of Bonaire a referendum so that Mr. Vinnies stop protesting and can go home. Dutch Parliament refused to respect the Bonaire people's choice, who rejected the current status and voted no. As one of the few uncompromised activists on the Dutch islands, Dutch Minister Plasterk and others were surprised and caught off guard, and empathically challenged Mr. Vinnies to stop speaking up and form a political party. NKBB embarked on SO's United Nations donation drive to go to the United Nations headquarters to expose Dutch undemocratic and illegal actions. June 26, 2016. With the blessing of the people of Bonaire, Mr. Vinnies stepped on a plane determined to visit the United Nations headquarters in New York City. Against all odds, history was made as Mr. Vinnies spoke at the United Nations C24. NKBB contracted Dr. Corbin and Dependency Studies Project to start the process of relisting Bonaire on the non-self-governing territories list. Meeting and lobbying with UN ambassadors, Vice Chair Sierra Leone, Vice Chair Cuba, Chair Venezuela. 2018, with great determination, Mr. Vinnies took the deposed government of St. Eustatius to the CARICOM headquarters to bring awareness about Dutch atrocities. Mr. Claude Van Putten, leader of St. Eustatius government. April 2018 historical meeting in Georgetown, Guyana with CARICOM headquarters secretary general. Presenting Bonaire Green Paper and Stasha White Paper to CARICOM. Mr. Finneys went to the CARICOM COFCOR meeting in the Bahamas to bring about awareness to all CARICOM countries. Guyana Vice President and Foreign Affairs Minister Mr. Carl Greenidge. In 2018 Mr. Finneys protested at the United Nations C24 meeting in Grenada. Grenada Foreign Affairs Minister Mr. Peter David. Mr. Finneys continued the mission of awareness throughout the Caribbean and Latin America. Barbados CARICOM Ambassador Mr. David Commission. Mr. Finneys has sent complaints on human rights violations by the Netherlands since 2012 to 2021 to Geneva Office of the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights. In 2019-2020 Mr. Finneys started and continued the process with and through the Vice Chair of the UN Chaired and member of the Task Force for the Netherlands to work towards the Universal Periodic Review 2021 to question and expose the continued racial colonial situation of the former Netherlands Antilles Islands. Mr. Finneys commissioned the NKBB Activist Office hoisting two United Nations flag. Lobbying and unifying with former Netherlands Antilles Islands. Curaçao Minister Charles Cooper donated towards the self-government assessment. There was three assassination attempts on life of Mr. Finneys September 2012, January 2015, June 2017. The government of Bonaire representing the Netherlands unlawfully arrested Mr. Finneys in presence of ministers and representatives of Holland and the Antillean Islands on Bonaire on September 6, 2019. Lobbying CAPOL Mexico, forming alliance with Antillean and Caribbean Islands. Participating in Caribbean and international online conferences. Sweaty Mandela, granddaughter of Nelson Mandela and Winnie Mandela. The story of the illegal annexation of Bonaire is documented in a book written by Mr. James Finneys. The illegal annexation resulted in a massive settlers' migration that destitute the natives Bonairean people. The last decade they were reduced and became the minority on their own island. They have no representation at any forum and have no voice to defend their rights. Please support our struggle to relist Bonaire on the non-self-governing territories list on the United Nations, Bonaire people's rights to self-determination, decolonization and reparations.